Fords with Ford takes you to the heart of the action.
England then, just, only just, but what a terrific night. 2-1 winners, two goals from Alan Shearer, 18 attempts each. Polish on target more often, 8 times compared to England's 6. The corner count as well, they won that too. Only one booking, perhaps one of the reasons that it was so good is that the referee allowed it to be good. Well, in the end, England clawed that back, 50% each. A sellout approaching 75,000 at Wembley tonight. Man of the match. They're going to be a surprise here. David Beckham, 13%. Pierce, 14%. Here we go. 59%. Alan Shearer, the others 14% between them. So let's have a word with England's new strike force, Les Ferdinand and Alan Shearer, with Nick Collins.
Well, Alan, Les, congratulations. Alan, first of all, were you surprised by how hard Poland made it for you tonight?
Not at all, no. We watched them on video, and they played the Germans. I'm not sure when it was, but they played the Germans off the park and should have got more than they got, and they got beat 2-0, so were you aware of what they could do? And after a very sloppy start, we've come back and got the goals we've deserved. But again, it wasn't a vintage performance, but just enough to get the win, which is the most important thing.
Les, how did you feel your partnership with Alan worked at international level?
Yeah, I felt it went okay. Like I said, I think it's getting better with each game that we play. And I think, there were signs there that it's still improving.
Well, you were involved in helping Alan, in setting up that second goal for Alan, weren't you?
Yeah, that's right. Ball came. I mean, he had a shot that he said was going well wide. Span off me, just laid him back on the edge of the area. Great finish.
Alan, was it like a continuation of Euro 96 with the atmosphere and everything here at Wembley?
Yeah, the atmosphere was tremendous again, and that gave us a lift. But we started sloppy for some reason, I don't know why, but we got it together and the crowd got behind us and we've given them the victory that they wanted.
And you've kept it going with the run of goal scoring in internationals, haven't you?
It's amazing how it goes, isn't it? I hadn't scored for however many games it was, and it seems that all the shots and whatever are going in now, so that's football.
All right, well, listen, you've been named the green flag man of the match for your two goals. Les, perhaps you present it to Alan. Well played, the pair of you. Well done.
Thanks, mate. Cheers.
Cheers. Thank you.
Yeah, really great night. Peter Reid, Ray Wilkins and Joe Royal with us. What do we make of it, gentlemen? Peter?
Yeah, 3 points. That's what we needed. But they were nowhere. 9-1 shots. They were a good side. Technically good. And if they had somebody who could stick it away like Shearer, it might have been a different story. But 3 points are the most important thing.
Did you enjoy the night, Ray?
I thoroughly enjoyed it, Richard. Yeah, I thought Les just about edged it. But again, it was a dodgy last 20 minutes for us. I thought they came back into the game. Although we had a couple of chances, they at least came forward and tried to press for an equaliser. And they made it a very entertaining night.
So they edged it, England, Joe, but did they deserve to edge it?
I think it was very close. I think Shearer's the edge, quite seriously. They had the same number of attempts on goal as we did. And Shearer was the edge with his clinical finishing. I hope they play that well against the Italians.
Yes, there was such a wonderful feel about the night, and what a shock when Poland went in front after just 6 minutes. Why do you think England started so badly, Peter? Alan Shearer couldn't put his finger on it.
I remember saying, stop the cross, because you get crosses in, you invariably get goals. And I think Joe mentioned they got a few crosses in early on. You can't afford to do it. I mean, we get a goal from one here now.
This is England's 20th minute equaliser, round about that time. Now, it looks simple, Ray, but what about the courage of Shearer?
I think that's the thing, as I think Trevor mentioned it in commentary, that he's obviously got one eye on the goalkeeper and one eye on the ball. I don't think Alan Shearer has one eye on the goalkeeper, to be honest, because he just makes such a clean contact with it. And this one, good grief. There was a lovely bit of interchange in between Les and Alan just before Alan had the shot. And Les was aware enough to roll it back in his path, but it was a hell of a shot.
What do you think's the message tonight, Joe?
I think it's a great start, and a great start for Glenn. I think he'll be a little bit worried that we were wide open at times, that they were running through our midfield. I thought Beckham played exceptionally well when he had the ball, looked a little bit strange defensively at times, whereas normally we played two fullbacks in the wide position. It was a big gamble, if you like, playing a forward player, and it worked to the extent when we went forward, but and Gazza also defensively in midfield at times was found a little bit wanting. Paul Ince was doing overtime. Nevertheless, the result is right.
Don't wish to be unkind when I say this, because it can be a great quality. Do you think Glenn Hoddle is a lucky manager?
It is a great quality for a manager, and hopefully, yes. But I think that was a very close game tonight. I'm glad we've won that.
What about the front two, Ferdinand and Shearer? What do we make of them tonight as we check out our wrap? Skippered by Alan Shearer tonight, of course, England. These two came into the game with 13 goals between them for Newcastle United this season. Did it work at international level, Ray?
I think there's promising signs, Richard. I thought tonight was a difficult game. I thought both central defenders were very strong guys. We see the defender there just muscling Les out of the game. And for someone to muscle Les out of the game, yes, he must be a tough chap.
Not many do it, do they?
No, they don't. He's a very strong fella. And the two guys that were marking them were both very physically very strong. I think it's obviously early days, but they definitely have the quality to complement each other.
Can two like Shearer and Ferdinand work at this level?
I think so, definitely, yeah. They have qualities that are going to hurt people. Alan brings people into the game very well indeed. Les can look for the ball on the other side of people with his dynamic pace. There he holds the guy off fantastically well for Alan to come in and rifle down to the roof of the net.
Is there more to come from them, Peter?
I think we've got a good squad. I mean, we're on about people on the bench, it's Sheddington on the bench, it's Fowler on the bench, and we've got two lads there who will get goals at any level. You know, and it's good when, as a coach or a manager with Glenn Hoddle has got that competition, especially in front positions. I'm still not sure about us at the back, though.
Serious doubts?
I mean, I know it's early on, but it looked as though the system, which Glenn likes, doesn't look as though it's honed in at the moment. And it's just something that worries me.
We did start the night very excited. There was a cautionary word of warning from Joe Royal that we weren't as bad as people made out going into Euro 96. Maybe not as good as people thought coming out of it. Is that the evidence that we've seen there tonight, Joe?
I don't think it's evidence. I think we've played a very good side tonight. Yeah. Despite their record, they were very, very good tonight. And, you know, just getting back to the Ferdinand Shearer partnership, the good thing is they will be allowed to develop at club level, and England should benefit from that, because they are probably our two best strikers around at the moment. But getting back to the England thing, no, we're a far, far better side than we're given credit for at times. But they showed tonight, in terms of technique, absolute technique and control, that they still had some very good players. Probably a better technique than us at times.
As well as that technique, did they surprise you with their desire?
They did, because they didn't buckle when they went 2-1 behind after such a great start. And I don't think England started badly. I think that they started so well that we didn't have much choice about it, quite seriously. But when we went 2-1 in front, I thought, hang on, they might buckle here, and they didn't. And they started the second half in the same vein. And realistically, they've had good chances. You know, they've had excellent chances to equalise.
Ray, would you share Peter's concerns about England defensively?
I think, obviously, when Glenn has used the system before, he's always used two defenders in the wider areas. And I think, obviously, they are naturally more gifted on the defensive side, and they will see things a lot earlier than perhaps David would see. Obviously, we're not going to get that ability on the ball that David Beckham will give us. But I think, Peter, is what he's saying is, at this level, you have to be very solid at the back, because if you give one of these fellas a chance, the ball's going to be in the back of the net. Yeah. And I think if we'd have been playing Italy tonight, then they might well have snatched a couple off us.
Again, don't wish to be unkind to Gareth Southgate, but when he went and Pallister came in, a recognised central defender, were you happier about that?
No, not really. I don't think it was the personnel, because I thought the big man, I mean, I'm a great lover of Pallister, I thought he took a little bit of time to warm up, really. I just think some of the lads aren't used to the system, and you can't do it overnight, and I think it needs working on, simple as that. But like everyone's saying, they're a good side. But we're improving with Shearer up there.
But do you persevere with the system? Is it worth persevering with, or do you go back, as Ray was saying before the game, to play on a lot of England's strengths, traditional strengths?
To be fair, when we got the chance, we did stick it in there, but the coach has got to stick to his principles and believe what his system's right, and work on it and work on it and work on it. It's only our second game in, two wins. Mm. You can't argue with it. But in some respect, it's good, because we know we've still got to improve. Mm. And like Ray says, I think if it would have been at Italy in a couple of occasions, their strikers, especially once when David rushed out quick, I could see an Italian lobbing into the net. But that's the cutting edge.
That one late on, perhaps.
Yeah,
Ravanelli might have tackled.
Yeah, that's the cutting edge in international football.
Can that system work, as it was here tonight, Joe, away from home? When England go to Georgia, would there have to be some adjustments made there?
I think that Glenn would play a defensive player on the right side, you know, instead of young David Beckham, who, as we've all said, we're all great fans of his as a footballer. But, you know, again, getting back to what Pete said, I think Southgate is really the most important of the three because he plays in three centre-backs at club level, whereas Pallister came onto it and, and took a little bit of time to get into it, the big fella. I mean, he's a terrific centre-half, but perhaps not used to the three centre-halves. And, you know, I think Southgate's important to us there because he does understand the read of the game. But, yes, I mean, the system can work. There's no doubt about it, and Glenn's got great faith in it. And as a coach, he'll stand by that.
But we're absolutely delighted about the outcome. There was one or two looks in here when Poland went one up, but England have won it 2-1. Let's have a look at the results from Group 2 tonight then. England beating Poland 2-1, we know about. Ravinelli's goal separating Italy and Georgia. So it's England on top, 6 points from two played. Then come Italy, Poland, Georgia and Moldova. Is it going to be a two-horse race, or are Poland going to make life difficult yet for a number of teams before this is all over?
I think Joe made a very interesting point. I hope they play as well against Italy as they did against us here. They obviously, I thought technically those guys out there were different class. Some of the use of the ball was wonderful, their movement off the ball. Now, we're very fortunate we could see the whole picture here, but on television you can't really see that as much. But their movement off the ball was just fantastic. And if they play like that against the Italians, then they might be able to take a point off them. But I think we're going to have a very, very tough game when we go to Poland, plus the two Italian games. I don't think it's a two-horse race, no.
I mean, I think Trevor Francis maybe made the point in commentary. They came here allegedly as no hopers, didn't they? Without an international track record recently, but they haven't half-turned in a performance tonight. Can they build on that?
I hope so. I certainly hope so, as I say, because we've got 3 points as a one game against them. Mm. But we also saw Italy struggle the other night against the table's so-called no-hopers. So it's not that cut and dried, and certainly if they get a good start on their own ground against sides, they're going to be a handful.
But isn't it nice to see England sitting top of that group?
It's brilliant. We're all delighted with that. I mean, and we're not criticising the performance so much. We just hope it carries on that way, you know. And it's been a great start for Glenn, and we all wish it to continue. But I'd just like to see us a little bit tighter around things.
Yeah. I thought it was a great game, honestly.
Yeah.
I really enjoyed it as a football match. Yeah.
I enjoyed the referee as well, who was a little bit lenient at times, but showed an awful lot of common sense.
But wasn't that nice to see?
Common sense?
Yeah. Well, you're not allowed that, are you?
No comments.
Ray Wilkins certainly went very quiet in the middle there.
I thought he did very well, actually. I thought he was excellent, the referee.
Ravinelli.
It is a man's game.
Very much so.
You know, there are a lot of tackles that go on, and especially in this level of football as well, that are quite naughty, but the fella never lost control of the game. He had the game under his control for the 90 minutes.
And presumably he was refereeing to FIFA's instructions, which is encouraging. Ravinelli scored again tonight. Mm-hmm. Middlesbrough face him. Rather, Sunderland face him and Middlesbrough on Monday night.
In there,
that's quite a frightening prospect already, isn't it?
That's easy for you to say, isn't it? Well, we've got a game on Monday and it looks like it'll be a hell of an atmosphere up there. And he's on fire. But if I start worrying about them, I won't enjoy my pint of lager tonight, so I'm not going to bother, I don't think. Next Monday I'll worry about it.
Plenty of time between now and then. In general, are we enjoying our domestic football right now in the Premiership?
Oh, it's been... I'm loving it. And the players are... My players are doing extremely well. I'm just desperate to get to finish a game away from home with 11 men, but I'm sure we'll do that in the next few weeks.
That's the first objective, isn't it?
Yeah. New team tactics.
Good, good. How's Scotland?
Very good. I'm thoroughly enjoying it. I've been there for a month. I'm going back for another month.
You've signed again for another month.
Yes.
You've made that benchmark. You wanted to be playing at 40, and you are.
Mm.
He's got 40.
Thankfully, dear.
Yeah.
Thankfully. But I just hope Paul's absolutely shattered from tonight's game, and he won't be running around too much on Saturday. But I'm thoroughly enjoying it. It's good fun.
Okay. Well, I think it's about time that we had a word from England's head coach. I think he's waiting to talk to us. Glenn Hoddle is with Nick Collins.
Well, Glenn, congratulations. You've won the points. It was an entertaining game, but how concerned were you with what happened in that first 20 minutes?
Yeah, it was. I don't think we really had a defensive head on right through the team. From front right to back, I felt that we really... maybe it was the crowd, maybe it was the euphoria of coming back to Wembley again, I don't know, but we've got to learn a lesson from that because we really only wanted to play when we had the ball, and you can't do that at this level. But in many respects, you know, you go 1-0 down in front of the home fans and sometimes the pressure's on you even more than when you're away. And all credit to the lads, they've turned it around with two magnificent goals from Alan.
Turned into a real genuine test in the end, whereas beforehand a lot of people thought the Poles would be sort of rank outsiders.
Yeah, I mean, Italy won't have an easy game against them. I know they're a good side, a very solid side. I felt we played the right side for the for the team that we were playing against. And I always felt that it was going to be very difficult to open them up, and they would try and hit you on the break, and they, to be fair, they did that well at times. But in many respects, you know, second half, we did that to them at times and really could have punished them. But no, it was a few concerns the first 20 minutes, but we didn't work hard enough as a team to win the ball back, and that's something we've got to become better at.
How pleased were you with the partnership up front between Shearer and Ferdinand?
Yeah, it worked well. As I say, they've got a very big physical side, and I felt we needed that strength up there. When I went and watched them against Poland, against Germany, I came back from that game thinking, yeah, it might be Les and Allen's sort of, that's that might be the partnership. But no, they've done very well. They had to endure a lot of physical challenges up there, and they did it well. And obviously, Allen's two goals were magnificent.
When England had gone behind so early on, what was going through your mind? Were you tempted to change anything round at that stage?
No. I think if you ever go 1-0 down in a football match and it's early and you're at home, you're still in with a hell of a good chance. So, you know, if it's 10 minutes to go, then obviously there's a different scenario. But in many ways, you have to keep your cool. And a few things sorted out at half-time. And all in all, very much delighted with the 6 points that we've got on the board.
And how pleased are you with the way that Alan Shearer has responded to being England captain? 3 goals in 2 games
yes.
Now.
You know, I said that I hoped it wasn't going to affect his goal scoring capacity, but it seems he's, like everything else in his life, he seems to take it in his stride. And you know, that's the temperament that the lad's got, and he come up trumps for us again. But he's a wonderful player, isn't he?
The group's starting to take a bit of shape now. England on top, but Georgia ran Italy pretty close tonight.
Yeah, it's a tough, we've said from the start, I feel this is a very tough group, probably the toughest, and Georgia and Poland are going to be difficult matches, home and away. I don't care what people say, at this level, there's no easy games now, there really isn't, and, you know, I think that's been proved tonight, but in many ways it was a good performance, and in many ways there's things for us still to work in.
All right, Glenn, congratulations. Thanks for joining us. Well done.
All the details behind tonight's scorelines coming up in the Sky Sports Centre, but let's just check them before we go. Estonia against Scotland, that match was abandoned. Full details coming up in the Sky Sports Centre. Scotland kicked off to win it. Republic of Ireland 3, Macedonia 0 in Group 8. Thoroughly enjoyed it tonight. Big, big thank you to Peter Reid, Ray Wilkins and Joe Royal. Live Football League action again on Sunday at 12 o'clock, Southend against Wolves on 3. Followed by Super Sunday from Highfield Road, Coventry City against Southampton. 3 o'clock start, Sky Sports 1. And the Monday night football this week features Sunderland and Middlesbrough. Roker Park's the venue, Sky Sports 1 at 7 o'clock. What a night here. Terrific night. It was England's and Alan Shearer's night. Goodbye for now.
Sky Sports with Ford takes you to the heart of the action.